What is going on YouTube? Is it gonna be louder to get one nicer 15 inch sub or two a little bit cheaper 12 inch subs? We're gonna run these on the meter and we're gonna see exactly which one gets louder and we're gonna go over why, so let's get to it. YouTube, thank you so much for checking in to another video, a little more scientific video on this. I wanna start out by saying there are a ton of variables that go into this sort of thing, but this is just gonna give you a basic idea of, is it better to grab one 15 inch sub or two 12 inch subs? So let's get into it. Now for this test, we are kind of comparing it dollar to dollar. So over here we have got one Skar EVL. This guy retails for just under 200 bucks. Whereas over here we have two Skar SDR 12s. They retail for right under 100 bucks. So dollar for dollar, we're gonna see which is louder. If you got 200 bucks, is it better to get a little bit nicer 15? Or better to get to a little bit cheaper 12s. Now, first thing to take into account is cone area. Again, there's some variables in this depending on how thick your surround is and whatnot, but just for simple math, a 12 inch subwoofer has a cone area of 113 square inches, whereas a 15 is close to 177 inches. So that means two 12s has close to 226 square inches, which does mean two 12s are gonna have a good deal more surface area than 115. Another thing to think about is your motor force. If we were to get an SDR 15 as opposed to two SDR 12s, assuming they all have the same size motor, we get more of a motor force by going with two subs. But since we are going to a bigger sub, we are of course getting more motor force from one EVL. So that being said, it's just gonna depend on what sub you get. You may get the same motor force out of 115 that you'd get out of two 12s. You might get less, you might get more. Just depends on the sub. Another thing to think about, generally speaking, 15s have a wider basket, which allows for a wider spider. This can help out with X-Max, which means your sub can mechanically move more. So that can help as well. Of course, here these guys are. So we've got more cone area. Possibly we might have more motor force. I don't know exactly. Also having a nicer 15, we do get a bigger coil. We get a bigger spider. We get bigger tensile leads. We get bigger terminals as opposed to these smaller guys here. So overall, we're getting a much nicer as far as quality goes sub, but we're only getting one. Whereas of course we're getting two cheaper, less quality subs. The other thing to think about is how much space do you have. If you have a bigger SUV or something, may not matter, you may not care, but with two 12s, you are gonna need a bigger box than you're gonna need with one 15, at least generally. So if you are confined on space, you may have to go with a 15. That being said, a 15 box is gonna be bigger in all dimensions. So if you're trying to fit a system maybe into the trunk of a little hatch car, you don't have a lot of height, a 12 inch subwoofer box, even though it's gonna be wider, generally speaking, it's not gonna be as deep and it's not gonna be as tall. So there may be some situations where it's gonna make more sense to go with two 12s than it would be to go with a 15. Guys, that is enough of me talking. We're gonna hook these things up. We're gonna see which one gets louder. We're gonna play at 35, 40, and 45 hertz. And we're gonna basically turn these things up until they mechanically max out. We're gonna see, are these guys gonna be louder? Or is the 15 gonna be louder? Leave a comment below letting me know which one you think is gonna be louder. Now real quick guys, this video is sponsored by Defbonts. They've been a huge, huge supporter of the channel over the last month or so. So definitely go check them out guys. Quick word from them, then we'll get back to the video. Now, what I love about Defbonts is that I have tested a ton of subs. Some have done really, really well, some haven't. A while back, I tested a Defbonts sub, and they actually hit me up and they said, hey man, you need to put that thing through a 5-minute 40 hertz test tone at its RMS power just to see what it can take. And I thought that was absolutely crazy, but I thought that was really cool. They reached out to me and asked me to do that. So since then, with every Defbonts sub that I have tested, that is exactly what I have done. And y'all, they make it through the 5 minutes, which is absolutely crazy. Well guys, go check out Alfred Audio in the description below. All right guys, back to the video. First off, we have the 15 hooked up in here. So of course, we're gonna play it at 35, 40, and 45 hertz. I have 8K amp in here, so we're gonna be able to max this guy fully out. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna see how loud we can get. We're then, of course, gonna do the same thing with the two 12s after, but let's see how this guy does. Real quick, just to make sure this is fair, Our box is right under 16 inches away from the end here. So when we put the 212s in here, we'll have it the same distance from the rear hatch. All right, we have the driver's side window open. We have the meter down in the kick. Got my base knob back here so we can roll into it. Got the SDR MM1 hooked up, ready to go. Of course, running it off this base 8K. Let's see what this thing does. All right, guys, first up, we have 35 hertz. All right, 5,155 watts. We got a 140.9. All right, we have this set to 40 hertz. See, the ohms rose more there, so we got 4,078 watts before it clipped. But we did get a nice bump. We got a 143.5. All right, we got set to 45 hertz. All right, 4,317 watts. And look at that, y'all. We got a 143.9. All right, that was the scores with the 15, guys. So now we're going to throw in the 212s. We're going to keep all my settings the exact same. We're going to try it again and see how they do instead. Let's find out what happens. Okay, these guys are all hooked up. 16 inches. 16 inches, so this is ready to go. Let's see how it does. We've got the meter hooked up. Everything ready to go. 35 hertz. Let's see what happens. All right, we did get a little more power before it clipped. Either way, we're maxing these subs out completely, so it shouldn't matter a whole lot, but 5,802 watts. And we got a 139.9. Okay, we're gonna try 40 hertz. 5,551 watts. And we did get a 143.3. All right, y'all, 45 hertz. 4,651 watts and a 144.4. All right, here are the final results. First off, we'll look at the dB scores. You'll see at 35 hertz, we were a little bit quieter by about 1 dB. 40 hertz, we were 0.2 dB quieter. And then at 45 hertz, we were actually 0.5 dB louder. Now, also looking at the power, you will see some discrepancies. Now, one thing I want to mention, the meter that I use quits going any higher once it detects some clipping coming through. So I actually pushed a good deal more power to the subs. Guys, we completely maxed them out, so they weren't gonna get any louder anyway. But again, because it started to clip, that's why it quit reading. So this guy over here, for whatever reason, started to clip at a lower power rating, so it only read that many watts. Whereas when we did this guy, again, for whatever reason, it clipped a little bit higher. So I just wanted to kind of explain that. All right, I found that super interesting, but what did we learn when comparing these two? Of course, the results would have been different if we would have had two Skar EVL-12s versus one Skar EVL-15. If you would like to see me do that, leave a comment in the description below. Maybe I'll do that for y'all. But of course, the point for this video was more to test out a dollar for dollar. What could you get for 200 bucks with two 12s versus one 15? And from the results that we saw, overall, guys, it's actually really, really close. At 35 and 40 hertz, the 15 was barely a little bit louder, whereas at 45 hertz, the 212s did win. Now again, there's a ton of variables that could have gone into that. Y'all, if I was to do this exact same test tomorrow, the results could come out a little bit different, hard to say. But I think point being, guys, it really comes down to how much space you have and what you want to do. My opinion would be that pick up whichever one fits in your space the best. All right, YouTube, that was super fun. I made another video going over one 15 EVL versus 112 EVL. That is now one of my top viewed videos. So I really appreciate y'all so, so much for that. Go check that one out and see the results for that. And if you want me to do more stuff like this, let me know. Maybe I'll do a 15 versus an 18. Maybe I'll do two 12s versus an 18. Who knows, guys? Let me know what you want to see next. All right, that's gonna do it for this video. I appreciate y'all so, so much. Stay tuned for more stuff coming up soon. But remember, as always, guys, keep basing on.